Welcome to today's sprint. This is shaping up to be another fantastic weekend. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting sprint. Lando Norris will lead us away from pole position, and Robert Schwartzman completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Oscar Piastri, Bottas, Max Verstappen, and Sainz, Leclerc, Gasly, Perez, and George Russell, Tictum, Ocon, Moore, and Tsunoda, Mick Schumacher, Stroll, Sebastian Vettel and Alex Albon, Joe and Nicholas Latifi. And with preparations almost complete, let's head trackside for today's sprint.
Launch map is good, but we need to learn the gears, so go into each one when you can. We're going to need some work on the brakes, so put some energy into them and warm the tyres as well, please. Decent parking. Let's try and get a good launch as the lights go out. OK, pick up rubber and bring it home.
So Norris, who moves further ahead at the top of the table? Let's move on to the constructors. McLaren continue to increase their gap at the top. There was also a strong showing from the Mercedes team today as they make their way up the standings. The grid is set then, so that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow where we'll be live with all the action. And until then, goodbye. Mountains for another chapter in the story of the Austrian Grand Prix. It's a short lap here in Spielberg with just 10 corners, 7 to the right and 3 to the left, making up the total distance of 2.6 miles. And expect to see a lot of cars running wide today, especially through the last corner, as the wet conditions make the cars skittish through the downhill sections. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. Lando Norris will lead us away from pole position, and Robert Schwartzman completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Oscar Piastri, Moore, Max Verstappen, and Sainz, Ocon, Mick Schumacher, Vettel, and Lance Stroll, Tsunoda, Latifi, Guan Yu Zhou, and Leclerc, Bottas, Perez, Pierre Gasly, and George Russell. Albon, they've taken a grid penalty, and Daniel Ticktum. And now it's time to head down to the track. Anthony Davidson is here once again for today's Grand Prix. We should talk about Williams. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do, and that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
Okay, so let's go through all the gears if we can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and... Superb parking there, mate. Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights. Okay, we've held position on lap one. That's not great, but it's not terrible. Stay focused. Okay, the virtual safety car has been deployed. Slow down and maintain a positive... Ah, you worked hard for that one. Congratulations. Well done.
It wasn't always plain sailing today, but it was a very important win nonetheless. Tell me, Ant, how do they manage to achieve this win?
I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on track was: speed. I know it sounds like an awfully reductive statement, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
Here come today's winning drivers, and what a race this was. This is a team that knows success very well in F1, and they're just itching for even more. Congratulations to the Alpine team for their excellent win today. Result for Lando Norris, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Well, there's no question in my mind, it has to go to George Russell. What a performance. He's got every right to be proud of what he accomplished out there today.
Let's move on to the constructors. No change at the top spot then, but with today's points, their hold on that lead is getting weaker. With that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport action. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when
I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell a team what to redevelop via the R&D screen. We had a major issue on the production line earlier this week, so the entire development package for the weekend has failed. Any redevelopments will need to be ordered from the R&D screen.